absolutely delighted you're here tonight. You might have come for a concert, but we welcome you to a worship service. The Bible says it's kind of amazing. Brother Mike Speck is here tonight with his very, very special guest. But he quoted a verse during the rehearsal, and it made this statement. And I preached on this verse Sunday morning. He put a new song in my mouth, a song of praise to our God. Many will see and fear and will trust the Lord. My prayer is tonight you don't only hear Christmas music, but you see it and you feel it and you know who we're singing about. His name is Jesus. We're here simply to make much of Jesus. So thank you for being here. We're going to worship. Pray you have a great, great time. Pray you have a fantastic Christmas. But what a way to start it off tonight. Father, I thank you, Lord, for the privilege together one more time. Lord, I thank you for these churches coming together. Lord, I thank you for Mike Speck and his trio. Lord, they're here tonight. And Lord, I pray, Lord, that you move in only a way you can move. And Lord, I pray when we walk from this place, it's not about a great choir, it's not about a great church, but it's about a great God. So we're here, we're simply here to make much of Jesus. It's in your holy name I pray. Amen.
Rejoicing with exceeding great joy. For good tidings of great joy is for all people throughout all of time. Joy has come, bringing hope, peace, and love to all mankind.
Joy that sustained you when everything fails
comes from the Father in heaven.
Joy that will lift you to heavenly realms
comes from the Father.
Oh,
rejoicing, laughter, and singing have all been a part of Christmas for as long as any of us can remember. This is the time of the year, and it's the only time of the year that we do this. We pull out, how many of you have cassettes at home? Do you have your cassette still? Some of these kids don't know what a cassette is. But some of us pull out our cassettes, maybe an 8-track, Lord help us. Our CDs, our record albums. Some of us have record albums to listen to our favorite Christmas music. Now, some of you won't admit it, but you're going to be listening to Mannheim Steamroller, Alvin and the Chipmunks, Christmas time is... The Carpenters. Some of you will listen to Bing Crosby or Elvis. Well, I have a blue. Do you know it? Blue. Oh, we shouldn't have done that. You know, it's amazing that a name like Elvis could cause such a stir. But a name can spark an emotion or a thought, bring a smile or a tear. You see, names are how we recognize one another. A name becomes synonymous with a person's reputation, behavior, or character. Have you ever wondered why you were given your name? How many of us in this room know the deciding factor, the deciding moment, the defining moment that gave us our name? I can guarantee many of you have wondered what your parents were thinking when they named you. That's why some of us have nicknames. In the days of the Bible, a name implied so much more than it does today. A name reveals something special about the child to which it was given. From the incident during their birth, to their temperament or appearance, from an everyday object, to the time of day they were born, Jewish parents named their children to give significance and meaning to the newborn child. But a baby was about to be born that had been given a name by God Himself. Jehovah God sent a messenger from heaven to visit a young Jewish girl that had found favor in His sight. God had chosen this pure young lady to be the mother of His Son. The angel was very careful to convey to her the name His Heavenly Father had chosen.
An angel from long ago bent down to earth below, and to Mary whispered low, call His name Jesus. Fear not. God has favored you today. You shall the precious name of Jesus.
Cherish that beautiful name. Cherish that wonderful name. Cherish that matchless name. That name is Jesus.
And Mary brought forth her firstborn son and wrapped him in swaddling clothes and laid him in a manger. And they called him Jesus, which means salvation. For he shall save his people from their sins. And the angel called him Jesus. Distinctive things about Jesus that cannot be said about any other person, beginning with prophecies that were written concerning his birth. Isaiah spoke of a virgin girl that would give birth to a son. The prophet Daniel wrote of a precise time in history when the anointed one would come. The psalmist foretold that kings from the east would visit him bearing gifts. Over 700 years before Jesus was born, the prophet Micah told of the specific location where all of this would happen. He revealed that Bethlehem was the place where a ruler would be born, and that this ruler had origins from long ago, from the days of eternity. So many prophecies, and every one of them, down to the smallest detail, were all fulfilled by this one born in Bethlehem. There had never been, nor would there ever be, a baby like him.
Thank you.
Christ is born, first to a most unsuspecting group of individuals. In the darkness of night, there was a divine display of sound and lights, startling those who first heard the announcement that a Savior was born. With amazement and wonder, they hurried to the place where the Savior lay. What an amazing night for those shepherds on the hills close to Bethlehem. Think about it. Angels dispatched from heaven interacting with ordinary men. Every time I read the Christmas story, and I mean this, I wrote the, found these songs and created this tonight. And God has so blessed it because it's all about Jesus. I want to lift up the Savior and make sure that everybody here knows that Christmas is Jesus. Yes. It's about Jesus. And when I began reading, trying to glean what pastor I could do, and pastor, thank you for letting us be here. Travis, I love you, little brother. I love you and your other two brothers that look so much better than you. But yeah, you can clap if you want to, but anyway. I love this family, and I've been here before, some of you meeting us for the first time, but we love this place. And we're so thankful and grateful that you've allowed us to be here. When I was writing all of this and thinking about all this, I really did come across something fresh, something I'd never seen before. I noticed the different names attributed to Jesus at his birth. Each name serves as a description of who Jesus really is and how he works in the lives of people. The angel speaking to the shepherds described the babe in a manger as Savior. He called the one wrapped in swaddling clothes Christ, which means Messiah. The angel also proclaimed that he, Jesus, was Lord. Mary and Joseph were commanded to give the unborn child the name Jesus. Yet the angel also called him Son of the Highest and Son of God, and that he would be called Emmanuel, which means God with us. When the Magi came, they inquired, "Where is he who is born King, and where could he be found?" Of all the names, the one that speaks most powerfully is the name Jesus. For it is in that name that we find the source of all that's good and all that's holy. You see, salvation is in that name. Healing is in that name. The very forces of nature bow to that name. Even the demons tremble at the sound of that name. The precious name of Jesus has changed the lives of so many. That name changed me. For that name saved me and gave me life. And because of that name, I've discovered the reason for living. I found peace and contentment the world could never give. I don't know about you, but there's no name more precious or lovely or wonderful than that name, Jesus. All we have ever needed is found in that most matchless, wonderful name.
There is a name that is so precious, a name so wonderful to me. This name worthy of all praises, because of him I am made free. That name is Jesus. Oh, how I love him, one who gave his life for me, because of love so unconditional, I will have life eternally. This name speaks peace unto my storm clouds. This name speaks calm unto my fears. And when I feel that no one loves me, his loving presence is so near. That name, oh, how I love him, one who gave his life for me, because of love so unconditional, I will have life eternal. Thank you.
sing with me.
Jesus, Jesus.
Song. It's easy to sing. Here's the way it goes.
Jesus, what a beautiful name. Son of God, Son of Man, Lamb that was slain. Joy and peace, strength and hope.
Worship the Lord with your hands. Praise Him with these hands. We worship. You may be seated. We worship that name. We give honor and praise to Jesus, our Redeemer, our Savior, the door to heaven. And we give thanks and praise unto God for sending his own son. Glory to God, for Christ the Messiah has come.
The word of the prophets centuries old. The birth of Messiah has been long foretold. That unto you, now unto you, Christ.
Celebrate Christmas because of his arrival. I know it's an old cliche, but he is the reason for the season. It's hard to fathom that in this culture that we live in, that's in some circles, what they want to do is somehow do away with Jesus, banning manger scenes, renaming Christmas trees, even schools that remove carols about the birth of Christ. It's sad for that innocent, perfect baby born in Bethlehem. Is God reaching out to a hurting world with his love and his promise of peace, joy, and eternal life? Christmas is far more than an annual holiday, for Jesus is far more than just a character in a religious story.
Yes.
You cannot constrain Jesus to any particular day. For all of history is related to him. The whole Bible is filled with references to Jesus in one way or another. In Genesis, He is creator, for all things were made by him. In Exodus, he's the deliverer, the Passover lamb. In Leviticus, he's the great high priest, our eternal sacrifice. And in Numbers, Jesus is the trusted guide, the cloud in the daytime, and the pillar of fire in the darkness of night. In Deuteronomy, he's the prophet who is greater than Moses. In Joshua, he's the captain of our salvation, the one who leads us into the promised land. In Judges, he's both judge and lawgiver. And in Ruth, he is our kinsman redeemer. In Samuel, Kings, and Chronicles, he's the prophet of the Lord and the reigning king. In Ezra, he's the one who fulfills his promises. In Nehemiah, he's the rebuilder of the broken and torn down walls in our lives. And in Esther, he reveals the providence of God. In Job, he is our everlasting redeemer. In Psalms, he is our shepherd and our song. In Proverbs, he is wisdom. In Ecclesiastes, Jesus is our only hope. In the Song of Solomon, he's the bridegroom, the rose of Sharon, the lily of the valley, the lover of our souls. In Isaiah, he's wonderful, counselor, the mighty God, everlasting Father, the Prince of Peace. In Jeremiah and Lamentations, he's the potter who puts our broken lives back together again. And in Ezekiel, he's the watcher of our soul and our high tower. In Daniel, he's the fourth man in the fiery furnace. In Hosea, he's the faithful forgiver and everlasting love. In Joel, he's the one who pours out his spirit on all flesh. In Amos, he's our burden bearer. And in Obadiah, he's our savior. In Jonah, he's merciful and full of grace. In Micah, he is the ruler called out from Bethlehem. In Nahum, Jesus is our avenger. In Habakkuk, he's the one who justifies by faith. And in Zephaniah, Jesus is the Lord, mighty to save. In Haggai, he's our stronghold in the day of trouble. In Zechariah, he's the one whose feet will stand in that day on the Mount of Olives as king over all of the earth. And in Malachi, he's the Son of Righteousness, rising with healing in his wings. In Matthew, he's Messiah and King. Mark, the wonder worker. Luke, the Son of Man. John, the Son of God. Acts, he's our ascended Lord. In Romans, he's our Savior. First and Second Corinthians, he's Redeemer and the Lord of glory. And in Galatians, he's the one who sets us free. In Ephesians, he's our chief cornerstone. In Philippians, he's the God who meets every need. In Colossians, he's the hope of glory. In First and Second Thessalonians, he's our soon coming King. And in First and Second Timothy, he's the mediator between God and man. In Titus, he's our great God and Savior. In Philemon, he's the friend that sticketh close than a brother. And in Hebrews, he's the blood that washes our sins away. In James, he's the great physician. First and Second Peter, the chief shepherd. In First, Second, Third John, he is our righteousness, truth, and love. In Jude, he is the Lord coming with 10,000 saints. And in Revelation, he is the Alpha and Omega, the beginning and the end, the King of Kings and the Lord of Lords. Wherefore, God has highly exalted him and given him a name which is above every name, that at the name of Jesus, every knee should bow and every tongue confess that Jesus is Lord.
Above his name, there is no other name. The one who is eternally the same. There is no other name. First and last, beginning and he is the one who made the common man his friend. There is no other name. Let every tongue proclaim and speak the name of Jesus. Magnify the precious name. Jesus, no other name but Jesus.
Just a moment. I think Brother Mike said it earlier. Christmas is Jesus. There is no other name greater than that name. And tonight we would like to offer you an invitation that if you don't know him personally, no better time than now, no better night than tonight to get to know him. You ask why they sing with so much power? It's who they're singing about. You see, Jesus lives in them like he lives in me. That's why we're passionate. That's why we sing. That's why we're here tonight. And if you don't know him, we would love to invite you to get to know him. I've got some fellows to come down here with me for just a few moments, and we're going to offer an invitation. And I would love to come talk to you about who Jesus is. But there are others here tonight that you've been encouraged. This Christmas might bring some difficulties, might bring some hard days. But I want to encourage you tonight that Jesus is the answer to everything you face. And you might want to come tonight and just kneel at this altar and just thank him for who he is. Thank him for being Lord of your life. But we'd love to offer you that invitation. If you don't know him, if you just want to come and pray and bow your knee, that name Jesus. We'd love to invite you. Would you stand as we sing?
Yeah. my Lord, and He is the mighty King, Master.
Night. I've requested a favor. That last song, you hit one of those notes, and I looked up for Jesus to come back. Could you do it again? I think you have another gear. Come on, brother.
Lisa, we'll start like at 3:29, 3 minutes and 29 in. We'll do that song, Pastor.
Thank you.
Y'all be seated for just a minute. Are you ready? Yeah, no other name, Lisa. And by the way, thank you, Lisa. You've been magnificent. And Brother Rusty Galloway up on the soundboard has done a magnificent job. Thank you. First and last, beginning and the end. He was the one who made the common man his friend. There is no other name.
More.
Wow. Are you ready for Christmas? Man, what a night. Thank you, Brother Mike Speck, for writing the narrative and everything. Great job. His trio, coming from Florida and Tennessee, I believe, or I'm sorry, Georgia. Just wonderful, wonderful, wonderful job. Travis, Justin, Jared. I love seeing churches combine to make much of Jesus. That's what we're about. We're on the same team. And I praise God for that. Our media booth has done a wonderful job prepping everything and getting everything ready. Flawless job. Just a great, great job. But we have come to make His name great. That name, Jesus. And I don't know about you, but I've been to many of these things. But I walk from this place tonight with His name on my lips. Jesus. Wonderful choir. Wonderful churches, but most of all, we serve a wonderful Savior. Amen. And so my prayer tonight as you leave this place, His name will be on your lips. Because there's a world out there that needs Him. He's the answer. He's the answer to everything our world faces today. The sweetest name I know, the name of Jesus. What a night. Brother Mike, anything else you want to say? Okay. Amen. Amen. What a Savior. What a Savior. We'd love to see you back 3 o'clock Sunday afternoon. We'll do this again. 6 o'clock, we'll do it again in Townville. We're not coming just to a service. We're coming to a worship service. Amen. So I pray you can come to each one of those those worship services. I'm just so thankful you're here tonight. I'm going to pray. We're going to dismiss. But praise the Lord, for He is good. Amen. Amen. Father, what a sweet, sweet spirit in this place. Father, You've moved in a powerful, powerful way. And Father, we've not only heard You, Lord, but tonight we've seen You. Lord, I'm thankful for these voices in this choir. Lord, I'm thankful for the narration. Lord, the soloists, powerful. Lord, but we sing for one purpose and one purpose alone, to make the name of Jesus great. And God, I pray this Christmas, wherever we go, whatever we do, we're all about making His name great. For it's in His holy name I pray. Amen.